هلو ان ديكور بوم، بليز سبسكرايب اند شير تو سي مور. To ensure best coverage, remove dirt and dust build up from house using two pressure washer. Work your way from top to bottom of house in a smooth, controlled manner, overlapping each stroke by 8 inches. Walk around entire perimeter of house, taking note of damaged surface such as wood, masonry, metal, siding or stucco. Apply exposed failure, crashes or holes using black knife. Once dry, lightly sand using medium girl sanding block. Once exterior is dry, walk around the perimeter of house, taking note of any loose or shaped paint. Please drop clothes along ground, then remove shaped and loose paint using a paint scraper or medium girt standing block. Fill any gaps between house and trim around doors and windows using extra caulk and caulk gun. If house has mixed master calcs such as siding and brick, add caulk along surface where different materials meet. Examine exteriors for any stains or visible wood. Not apply one coat of stain blocking primer to area using bench brush. Cover doors, windows and lighting fixtures using plastic sheeting blend step. Load flat or eggshell extra paint color into paint sprayer depending on state of you. Apply one or two coats of fillet or eggshell extra paint to enter house. Be sure to work your way from top to bottom in the smooth, controlled manner, overlapping each stroke by 9 inches. When changing exterior color from light to dark, to light, start with coat of primer to ensure proper cover. Primer is not necessary when a fresh coat of exciting color is being applied. Remove plastic sheeting from doors, windows and lighting fixture. Add 2 coats and exterior smoothing paint colors woodwork and doors using bench brush. Remove drops closes. Walk you through the steps of painting the exterior house from pre-bib through finishing touches. Few features of your home make any immediate visual impact. The exterior paint job, stubble applied blend your pride in your home and helps define personality. You may be tempted to get straight to painting, but diligent prep work is circle a professional looking finish according to Dan Laws of Maroon Paint. 95% of good painting is having good service. Before painting a new house with a stucco exterior, let the stucco cure for at least 28 days. Paint will not adhere properly to uncured stucco and may paper appear shelly or dusty. If you are in a hurry, here is a tip from Rich Lux Construction Manager. for custom revolution and addition. Keep the sock wet by spraying it with house. If it washed daily, it can cure in a week to 10 days. If you are painting an existing home, inspect the extra walls and trim of shipping, billing, medium and other imperfection. Cure of mildew by applying a strong bleach solution with garden sprayer. The pressure clean the intra exterior to remove dirt and old paint that has come loose. Before you pick up a paint roller, grab a tube of HV12C and cracks as well as the joints where one type exterior materials meet another. This includes the window frames, doors frames, molding and fixed supports. If an old stock surface has chips or bends, patch them with a new stock and allow time care. Replace wood siding or fascia boards that show signs of rotting, cracking and wood. Trim and doors to ensure an ideal surface to painting. To get the most out of your paint job, trim with a cold sealer. Sealer has high resin contact, can explain that goes over old paints, locks everything in a place and create good surface for the new paint adhere to. If you are repainting walls that have become shell or dusty, select sharply while a sealer paint will not stick to dust surface. As for a new construction, Lexor Prime works well for veiny and most wood setting. If you are working with stock that isn't fully cured, you can apply a hot stock primer. This sidesteps that waiting period, allowing the surface to accept paint as soon as the primer dries. It is the best offer to late stock care from the recommended time period out impossible. Check the label on your primer or sealer to determine how long to wait before you begin painting. A good extra paint is 100% acrylic. The formula consists three main components: pigments, which provide the color; binders, which hold the pigment to the wall; solvents, which make the paint breathable. Today, most extra paint are water-based. As paint dries, the solvent exports, leaving behind only the pigments and binders. These are known and volume salts. High quality paints are generally higher. Quality paints are generally higher in volume salts. They may also have better brights, which will hold the pigments less longer. This improves durability. To determine the percentage of volume salts in a brand of paint, check website or ask your local distributor from the technical date sheet. In general, paints labeled Premier or Super Premier are likely to be higher in volume salt than batch brands. When it comes to color selection, there are so many choices that shouldn't can overwhelming. If you are not sure where to start, spend some time driving around your neighborhood to see what appeals you. Keep in mind that color will fade sooner than more muted ones. Be sure to consider the stylistic elements of your home. Choose color that complements your roofing material and any brick or stone you are having trouble deciding between two shades. Paint samples was on a section of your home's exterior. Look at the result during different times of day to see which one like best. Before getting your hair set on creation color, check well your neighborhood association and local building department to make sure there are not restriction or paint color in your area. The ideal way to paint extra walls called